Bob Carpenter Center for Delaware men's basketball. 11-14 Blue Hens are 4-8 in CAA play. They host the second place Northeastern Huskies with a record of 15-9, 8-4 in the CAA. I'm Scott Klatskin alongside Bill Harmon on 94.7 WDSD-FM, your home for Blue Hens Sports. And Bill, Delaware looking to snap a six-game losing skid.
The challenge tonight will be playing against such a fine Northeastern team. Well-coached, balanced, very versatile offensively, love to shoot the long-range shot, but very effective at running their motion offense, and a really solid defensive team. So a real test here. I expect Delaware to come out, try to pound the ball into the post, run some things for Ryan Allen early on to see if we can't get him going. And I'm really looking forward to watching Mosley and Bryant try to attack this man-to-man that the Huskies play.
Let's get to your starters, presented by your local Chevy dealer. Visit ChevyDealer.com because they do switch tonight for the Blue Hens as Jacob Cushing enters the starting lineup after a career-high 19 points down at Elon. He'll replace Sky Johnson, who had started in three of the previous games. The three guards remain Ryan Allen, Anthony Mosley, and Darian Bryant, and Eric Carter is the man in the middle. Eric Carter, one of the captains, along with Anthony Mosley. Since Ryan Daly has been injured, Carter stepping up, 41 points, 61% from the field, and 31 rebounds in those three games since Ryan Daly's absence. Martin Inglesby, in his second season as head coach of the Blue Hens, his assistants Bill Phillips, Corey McRae, and Torian Jones, Pat Rogers, director of operations, and Danny O'Connor, director of development for Northeastern. They'll also start three guards and two forwards, Sean Osius, Max Borsico, and Donnell Gresham, along with Anthony Green and Vasa Pushitsa. Osius, Pushitsa, and Gresham, the guards. Borsico, kind of a swing player, can go either way in that guard forward slash position. Anthony Green is the big in the middle at 6'10", 252. Doesn't do much on offense, but he can block some shots. Led the CAA with over a block per game last season, 41 on the year. Bill Cohen, always impressed with him. 12th season as head coach of the Huskies. Coaching staff, Chris Markwood, Brian McDonald, Bobby Martin, and Tom Murphy. Longtime coach at Hamilton College.
The great story is that Billy Cohen played for Tom Murphy at Hamilton, was a four-year starter and became a captain, a terrific shooter. Said they are always in great shape and shot the ball a lot. Tom Murphy, who has been around the game for a long time, a Springfield 1960 graduate, once at Union Academy in upstate New York, Scott, he won 104 consecutive basketball games. That's pretty impressive.
Very impressive stuff. What's your longest streak? 103? It's around there.
I don't have any strings, Scotty.
Very humble,
but you're too kind.
Delaware comes out wearing their home white uniforms, blue Delaware across the chest with yellow outline, and Northeastern on their road, black uniforms with a red Northeastern across the chest and white numbers. It'll be Green and Carter jumping things off. Tim Comer, Jeremy Mosier, Brian Zink, the officials in tonight's game. All time, Delaware leads 28-25 in a very tight series between these two teams, although Northeastern took the earlier contest up in Boston. Delaware going left to right, and a rare winning of the tip by someone not named Eric Carter's Northeastern will get the basketball first and operate from the right wing. Anthony Green with a touch. He'll go over to Osius, the team's second leading scorer from Boynton Beach, Florida, at a Grandview Prep. Kick out, Osius, corner three. Delaware late to get to him, a miss, and on the run comes Champ Mosley. He'll slow up, allow his offensive teammates to catch up.
We'll see a lot of man-to-man for Northeastern, a little bit of 2-3 zone from time to time, and a bit of three-quarter court pressure just to confuse and slow down Delaware's attack.
Ryan Allen had the hot hand against Elon, 26 points. He works to Mosley, who gets it to Cushing, inside to Eric Carter, 11 to shoot. Allen on the left corner, back inside to Carter, left block. On Green, 5 to shoot, spins baseline, high off the window, can't get the bounce, and it goes to Pushitsa, eyes up the floor as he gets across half court, working to the right side. Now center of the floor to the foul line, inside, Borsico's first touch, reverse, no good. Green, an offensive rebound, powers back up strong, and in. Green, not a big rebounder, but able to get the O-Rev that time in the first point.
Green takes up an awful lot of space on that weak block. Eric Carter had a body on him, but the power of Green just was able to negate Eric Carter's positioning.
He sure does. 6'10", 252. Allen, a jump shot from three, is long. Back iron, long rebound out to the three-point arc. Rebounded by Sean Osius. And he gets inside the arc, will bring it back out. Green left alone. Gresham had the hot hand against Delaware. 17 points up in Boston. Inside again, they go to Green. He's got 4 points and a 4-0 lead.
That's that weak side pick and roll where they've isolated the big man in the pick and roll situation. A really nice pass there, dropping it off to Green, who's getting a great start against Eric Carter early on.
Green 2 of 2 tonight. He was 3 of 3 against Delaware and Matthews Arena earlier in the season. Here's Mosley on the drive baseline, lost it out of bounds. He's had some trouble with turnovers as of late and gets another one there. Delaware yet to score, almost 2 minutes in.
Well, Anthony took it just a little too deep. I know he's trying to probe and attack with his left hand, but that time Green had come off and help, and he's such a big man, it's hard to get by him. I like it when Mosley goes down the middle of the lane.
17-54, first half, Northeastern. 2 of 4 from the field to start. Pushitsa makes it 3 of 5 as he hits one from about 18.
You cannot sink under the screen with Pushitsa. And Anthony Mosley had him, just got pinned by Green, who again sets a mammoth screen. Green having a lot to do with this early start for Northeastern.
17-34, first half. Delaware looking for their first points. Right blockage, Carter. He's 0 of 1. Double team comes, but too late as he spun to his right-hand baseline, and Delaware is on the board.
Great identification there by Eric Carter, turning immediately to his left as Pushitsa had come in, digging in off the pass. A good low post offense there by Eric Carter.
Oshias sends it back to Green. A steal from Anthony Mosley. He's ahead of the pack alone, and Anthony Mosley lays it up and through.
That's vintage Anthony Mosley taking advantage of an errant pass, a diagonal out of the corner. Did a great job of anticipating and finishing it. That's what I love Mosley to do, get more offense out of his defense.
Sure is. 55 steals a season ago, led the CAA, steal number 27 on the year. Four champion, it's 6-4 Northeastern. Jump shot blocked by Bryant along the baseline, left by Oshias. Delaware chance to tie or take their first lead on this possession. No look underneath to a cutting, pushing. What a look by Mosley.
The key was Mosley's look, as you mentioned, because he had his eyes up, dribbling perfectly, and Jacob Cushing running the floor. It was a great finish by Jacob. That's what we like to see him do, take advantage of some mismatches in the open court.
Although it may not have been a look at all. It was almost a no-look pass by Anthony Mosley. A lob inside and another steal for Delaware. Hens on a run, 6-0 run. Can they make it 8-0? The Euro from Mosley, no good. Rebound Carter, and the Hens on top, 8-6.
Eric Carter taking advantage on the offensive glass because Anthony Green had fallen down at the other end going for that lob pass. Those are the mistakes that Northeastern does not want to make early on in the game here on the road.
Hands on a 8-0 run. It could continue after the miss in the corner by Borsuko. Northeastern going to sub 3 players in at the next whistle, which will be our first media timeout. Carter underneath to Mosley. Mosley didn't know what he wanted to do with it there. Lost it, got it back. Could have been a self-pass, but they allowed it to continue as he has it deep right side. Brings it to the left, does Mosley. 9 to shoot for Cushing. 8 as they bring it back to Champ with 6. He has to operate with 5. Inside out dribble. Cushing a 3-point shot with 3 on the shot clock, and it's no good for Jacob Cushing.
Good use of the clock by Delaware, but they've got to get engaged a little sooner at about the 8-second mark and attack. That was at about 5.
Tough spot for Jacob Cushing. Had no choice but to release on a 3. 8-6, Delaware's lead after trailing 6-0. Oshias drives, kicks out Pushitsa, wanted the foul, got it, and a chance for a 4-point play when we come back. Delaware trails now at the first timeout, 9-8, almost 5 minutes in.
That's too bad.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing. It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Into the Bob Carpenter Center. One of our listeners to shop Acme and stock up for the game with party trays, wings, and store-made guacamole and chips. Acme, your favorite local supermarket. Delaware down 9-8 after Avasapu shoots a three-point shot. He can make it a four-point play at the free throw line when we return the foul on Anthony Mosley. And Bill, you were able to talk with some of the coaches for Northeastern, Tom Murphy and head coach Bill Cohen, and they chatted with you about many things, but one of them, the inconsistencies throughout a ball game their team goes through.
They were talking about it not only in inner game, but intra game, and that's been their problem. They'll have these little spurts where they'll play really well, as we saw and talked about the start of this game, and then they'll digress for some reason. Maybe their defense isn't as locked in, or they'll take a couple quick or bad shots. And that's what they're striving to do. I asked them, how do you correct that? And they just said, you try to work on your strengths and minimize your weaknesses. It was a good answer, and there's not a whole lot you can do at times.
Free throw good from Pushitsa. He's an 80% free throw shooter, third best on the team, and now a two-point advantage for Northeastern. Started the game up 6-0. Delaware went on an 8-0 run and a four-point play by Northeastern. Now Sky Johnson in the game. He spins right past Murphy, collects himself, and was fouled on the floor before putting the shot up by Thomas Murphy. Murphy playing for the first time today. First wave of subs coming in. Bolden Brace in the game as well for Northeastern. And we also see for the first time Devon Begley. For Delaware, Sky Johnson, the first substitution. Ryan Allen on the curl, and he knocks in a deep two-pointer from the corner left side off the inbound.
The screening action was excellent there to allow Ryan Allen to go right to left to rise up into his left-hand jump shot.
Score tied at 10. Brace shoots a three as he loves to do. He made five against Delaware up in Boston last season, but a miss. Allen on the dribble drive, quick steps, and Begley couldn't keep up with him. He fouls.
Well, Ryan Allen has a great feel for when to attack. He had the defense backpedaling there, not sprinting. They had not set up, and he recognized that and runs right through Begley's shoulder. A really good play by Ryan Allen to draw the foul.
Second foul on Northeastern. And the inbound goes to Mosley with a score tied at 10. 14-26, first half. Bryan a couple dribbles on top. Left side, it's Allen. Allen defended by a heck of a defender. Begley shoots around him, and his three is no good. 0-2 start from distance for Ryan Allen. Rebound by Gresham. He's bumped, kicked out to Begley. Back to Pushitsa. Pushitsa, 6 points already for Northeastern. The redshirt junior operates the left side. Corner, Brace, wide open for a three. Can't do that, he knocks it through.
Well, Pachisa comes off the screen. Delaware was trying to slide through it. A little bit of a flat show, but that allowed him to get down the lane. It drew the help, Brace wide open. 80% of his field goal attempts are from the three, Scott.
Kyrie Walker off the bench. Baseline jump shot too strong. Johnson tips it to himself, tipped out of bounds. Now a save into the hands of Gresham, and Walker trying to intercept what was a baseline save by Pushitsa, ran into Gresham and gets called for his first foul.
Pushitsa was very fortunate there because Walker read it. He was just a little slow. He would have intercepted and laid it in. You have to be so careful when you save the ball underneath your own basket. You have to save it directly to a teammate who's usually positioned right in front of you. A very risky play. I don't mind the foul there by Walker, Scott, trying to make a play.
Second foul on Delaware, first on Kyrie. A 13-10 lead for Northeastern. On top is Murphy. Begley with the basketball. Pass to Murphy from the foul line. High arcing jump shot, no good. And a rebound by Ryan Allen. Head up the floor where he wants to run. Goes to Mosley, streaking through. Shot blocked at the rim, but Gresham got a piece of the hand of Anthony Mosley. And Champ will shoot two.
That play is all to do with Ryan Allen pushing the ball before Northeastern can set up their very solid man-to-man. Anthony Mosley running the right-hand wing. Went at the perfect angle, a straight line drive right over top of the block. That's really good open court offense by Ryan Allen and Anthony Mosley.
Champ at the free throw line where he shoots 71% on the year. He's been up and down throughout the season. There's been games where he won't miss, and there's games where he's missed four or five times, but he makes the first free throw and Delaware's deficit just two. Early stages of this game, 13-22 first half, and Mosley knocks in both.
Delaware going to show a little pressure on their own, a little 2-2-1 three-quarter court again. This is not designed to get a direct turnover unless it were to happen, more to just slow down the attack of Northeastern.
Murphy sets the screen for Pushitsa. Delaware goes under, and Pushitsa makes him pay.
We've already mentioned you cannot do that. You've got to make sure we're hard hedging from the backside or get over the top of it, so he's forced to dribble the ball into our help, and then we can recover.
Pushitsa is shooting just 12% from three-point range over his last four games, but 2 of 2 tonight and still 40% on the season. Delaware's deficit is 4, 16-12. 14 to shoot for Mosley. Around the screen, all the way to the cup with the left hand. Anthony Mosley at his best.
That's a great job by Mosley. Coming off the screen by Sky Johnson on the right side, getting down the lane with his left hand. There is no rim protector in right now with Green out of the game from Northeastern standpoint.
Mosley already with 6 points. He leads Delaware. 16 to 14, Northeastern's lead. Pushita, height advantage over Mosley, takes him down low. Misses, tapped out to Gresham. Brace will reset. He's a big guy, but he can shoot. And now he drives to the cup, past everyone, an easy layup.
There was absolutely no help anywhere in the lane for Delaware. They've got to be sure they're hedging in from the backside to not allow any straight line drives. Brace, known as a three-point shooter, did a nice job there putting the ball on the floor.
Under 12 minutes we go as Mosley goes into Sky Johnson, turns and faces on Murphy. An attack by Sky Johnson with the running right hand.
Excellent recognition, the fact that he could take Murphy off the dribble. Murphy should have leveled him out. Sky Johnson really imposing his will with a wonderful running old-fashioned Princetonian hook shot.
You like that one, Bill. 64% shooting on the season is Sky Johnson, but he's called for a foul there. That means Gresham will be at the stripe when we come back. 18-16, Northeastern on top by two. 11:39 left in the first. This is what it's... Northeastern both shooting 50% from the field to start this one. The Huskies up 18-16, 11:39 left in the first half. A portion of this broadcast presented by First State Orthopedics, the team taking care of Delaware. Visit firststateortho.com. Anthony Mosley, a couple games back, became the 40th player in school history to reach 900 points, playing like a man that wants to get to 1,000, 6 points already for champ.
Well, he's on well on his way. What I like about Anthony Mosley tonight is he's responded to Martin Inglesby's challenge. He's playing to his strengths. Makes a steal off the diagonal pass for one basket. He gets to the foul on another, and then he attacks in the fast break. And I really like the way he's playing. He looks very mobile tonight. He needs a little bit of help on the really fine score of Asa Pusiska, but that's not all his fault. He needs to have some hedging in there. Pusiska has to be defended when he goes over top of those screens, or he will pull up and continue to shoot the three.
At the stripe is Donnell Gresham. Makes the first, misses the second. Gresham, an 80% free throw shooter on the year, splits a pair. Delaware with the basketball, down by three, and Anthony Mosley brings the ball up the floor in front of the Huskies bench on that left side. Dribbling with his left hand, gets it to Allen. Allen, 2 points so far. Leading scorer on the team with Daly and Anderson out, and Ryan Allen, another deep two, so smooth off that left hand.
What I love there, Ryan Allen understood that his defense sunk underneath the screen, much like we're doing, unfortunately, against Northeastern. He rises up immediately into that shot. Great recognition.
Gresham gets Allen in the air, steps underneath the three-point arc, fires away from two, and it's short off the side of the rim into the hands of Kyrie Walker. Ahead to Allen, sideline right, 25 to shoot. For the freshman, driving on Brace, help comes, kicks out, Mosley, extra pass Bryant, he'll drive, foul line, paint inside Walker, one dribble into Miller, gets it back, but a jump ball as Walker shot it into Miller's hands, and it'll stay Delaware basketball on the possession. That was a quick jump ball call there.
Yes, it was. Right. I like the fact that Walker worked underneath the basket, and a nice play by Darian Bryant driving down the lane. What Walker should have figured out quickly was which side of the basket Miller was on, and he would have pulled up short. The rim would have acted as a protector.
15 on the shot clock. Allen uses none of it. A baseline jump shot, a miss. Walker with a putback, but but they'll wave it off as they'll say he used his hands underneath to free himself up to grab the rebound.
Walker is so athletic and so quick, Scott, that he doesn't have to work his hands. He can just use his mobility advantage to get himself in better position. It's a habit that a lot of players have. Just play with your hands vertically.
Second foul on Walker, fourth on Delaware. As Begley drives right to left, loses it. Ball on the floor, gets it back. Looking to pass out. Pushita lost, and he's wide open for a three. Lucky break by Delaware as that one rattled out.
Delaware doing a nice job in their man-to-man of blocking out and making sure Northeastern is only getting one shot, only two offensive rebounds so far for them.
A 19-18 lead for Northeastern. Delaware led when the score was 8-6, part of their 8-0 run earlier in the game. We're halfway through the first half of basketball as Allen hesitates, pulls up, jumpers smooth again.
Scott, he is so quick, and he's got that little step-back shot when he drives right and then pushes back off his right leg to get separation. Wonderful offense there by the freshman.
Allen, 3 of 6, 6 points. Pushita operates, right wing. Foul line now is Begley. To Pushita for a three, misses again. Two possessions in a row for Pushita.
Well, he's regressing to the mean in terms of his recent shooting, but these are really good looks. I think he's too good a shooter to be left that wide open very often.
Averages 16 points per game, leader on this Husky squad. Allen, trap baseline, kicks out to Johnson, gets it back. 14 to shoot in front of Bill Cohen on that left side on the wing. Oshias defense, great defender, leads the league in steals. Allen, a pass to Mosley, 5 to shoot. Champ behind the back, using his right hand. Short offensive rebound. It was Johnson and Walker in the area, and neither communicated which was going to grab the rebound and ended up going out of bounds.
Sometimes you're trying so hard to get in position that you don't recognize who's next to you. Unfortunately, as you described it, they were two teammates. There's not much you can do there other than just have that peripheral vision work for you and understand, hey, I don't want to knock it out of my teammates' hands. So a bad luck play there. Good hustle by both Sky and Walker.
20-19, the count. Delaware on top by one. Gresham top of the key to the right side. Begley in front of the Delaware bench. Cross court to Gresham. In the corner, Osius. Walker closes in quickly. 13 to shoot for Gresham. Screen comes from Miller. Now it's Osius. Baseline left. Walker can't pick up that third. Does it. In defense. 5 to shoot for Gresham. Gresham with 4 to shoot. Kick out Begley. NBA range 3 forced up with 1 to shoot. And he knocks it through.
That is a shame because Delaware did a great job of defending what I thought were really a couple excellent patterns there and some movement by Northeastern. If they keep playing like that, we're going to be okay defensively.
That's a tough break for 29 seconds worth of really solid defense by Delaware. 22-20 lead for Northeastern. Walker steps into his own shot from just above the free throw line and hits.
I love Kyrie off the mid-range because he can elevate so well, does a nice job of gathering himself as he rises up off the hard dribble.
Shoots at the peak of that leap. And boy, he gets up there. You're right, Bill. Corner three, brace. Not a good angle, and he misses into the hands of Eric Carter, who had 13 rebounds last time out.
This Northeastern team will hunt out their three and look for it from almost every player on the court, even some of their bigs. Jeremy Miller loves the three-point shot.
Carter coming off his seventh double-double on Saturday with the ball in the post, but he loses it to Jeremy Miller ahead to Begley. Begley does not have numbers. Corner to Brace. Brace from where he missed last possession. Back to Begley. Begley with the left hand. Foul line gets in closer. Hangs doesn't have a passing partner and stolen away by Walker. Down the floor he goes. It's 3-on-2. Walker will take it himself to the rim. Missing. Rebound Mosley. He settles. Puts it back up. There's another miss. Carter this time, and he's fouled. He'll shoot two when we return. 22 all is the count as we go to break with 7:26 to play in the first.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing, maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously, or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Tie score 22 all, 7:26 to play first half. Delaware versus Northeastern. I'm Scott Clancy alongside Bill Harmon. And if Ryan Allen makes a three-pointer in this game, it'll be 23 games in a row. He'll pass Alfonso Dawson and Ty Rulon Washington for second longest streak in school history. We know he can knock down three. He's done it 62 other times this season, but he is very dangerous when he can pull up from that two-point range.
He certainly is. First of all, he has a really good handle. Second of all, he recognizes, because he's played enough in terms of attacking in his own offense, to realize when the defender's off balance, and that's immediately then when he drives his foot in the ground and steps back to create some space. What I like about him, Scott, he's really working hard off the ball when he doesn't have it to get himself open, and his teammates are doing a nice job screening for him.
Ryan Allen, one of only six freshmen in the country, averaging 2.5 three-pointers made per game and 15 points per game. He's in a class that also includes Trey Young. Young, a little bit more than 15 points per game, almost 30 points per game as a freshman from Oklahoma. He's impressed. He's run away with that National Player of the Year.
Well, yes, but he also is a massive volume shooter.
He's a volume guy.
And a good move here by Martin Inglesby just to get Ryan out for a quick breath.
Carter, who's shooting so well from the free throw line over his last five games, 82%, makes 2 of 2, and Delaware back on top. There's some guys up the road at Villanova that probably will be saying Trey Young doesn't have it. Here's Walker with the slam in transition.
He makes the play at the other end, but Darian Bryant did a great job of poking that ball away to Walker on the post up. So really nice defense there by Darian.
Walker with a great slam. I was referring to Jalen Brunson, of course, up the road at Villanova, just to finish the thought on the National Player of the Year conversation. Northeastern answers with a bucket. They trail 26-24. Cushing, a three-point shot open early in the shot clock, and a miss for Cushing, wearing that mask as he came back a couple weeks ago after a nose injury kept him out of 10 games. Pushita inside to Green. Green thought it was deflected. It was not, and a turnover by Northeastern.
And that's the scouting report on Vasa. At times he drives in a little deep, tries to make a great play instead of staying grounded, reverse pivoting, what you would see Brunson do, which Villanova is really good at, so they don't create the turnover. And that time Delaware did a nice job of rotating on the backside to affect the play.
6:31, first half of basketball. Delaware up by two. It's 26-24. Inside of Carter, draws the foul from Anthony Green.
Nice job there by Darian Bryant, throwing the ball directly to the midsection of Eric Carter, who had a nice post-up position just off the block on the left side against Green, and then Green had no counter but other than to foul him with his midsection.
First foul on the 6'10 junior from Quincy, Massachusetts. Mosley in the corner, he'll bring it back out. Picks up his dribble, Walker helping out. Walker looking for his offense a bit more today, I like that. Out of Kyrie. Here's Darian Bryant slicing through, floats it up and in. And that's exactly what Coach Inglesby talked to us about in the pregame.
That's old school Darian Bryant going left to right. He's got that floater. He's very elusive in there because he's got a wonderful first step.
And shooting 52%, 12 of 23. 14 of their points, that's half, coming in the paint. A 4-point advantage, their largest. Osius to Gresham in the corner. Mosley all over him. Here's Green. One dribble to Gresham. Sets the screen. Gresham goes around. Five to shoot. Green inside. Kick out Osius. Releases with two on the shot clock. It's strong and a rebound by Anthony Green. He's bumped. And the foul after another great 28, 29 seconds of defense for the Hens. But it doesn't result in a stop for the second time.
The shot was missed so badly that it kicked out beyond the 50-50 area where really the offense had the advantage. Delaware really engaged, doing a great job of moving their feet, figuring out exactly what Northeastern's doing offensively and staying in front.
Pushita, no one in front of him, and he knocks down a three. How do you get lost like that off an inbound?
Well, it was a down screen by Green as he came up after inbounding the ball. Darian Bryant's got to tag that and be there on the catch a little bit sooner.
5:20 to go, and the lead is one for Delaware's. Cushing drives. He's held up on the kickout, and a foul against Northeastern, and that's his sixth on the Huskies.
Delaware is clearly attacking Northeastern downhill. By that, I mean they're driving from the top and from the wings directly at the basket, trying to create some fouls, also get to the basket, and that's going to open up activity on the weak block for Eric Carter and Sky Johnson.
Bryant looking for an inbounder. Goes to Carter, and Walker has it now top of the key. 17 to shoot for Delaware, and Bryant, corner this time from three, and Darian Bryant has five tonight.
It's amazing how making one little move in the middle gets you going. Then Darian Bryant had much better arc on that last shot. He got his feet set and extended his shooting elbow.
Darian Bryant had 5 points total in the last two games, five tonight for the redshirt junior transfer from George Washington. Gresham inside Green. Green with the slam over Allen, and that should be a technical foul. It is not. I thought he hung on a little bit and tried to kick his legs towards Ryan Allen. Allen speaking with Tim Comer about it as he walks the ball up the court.
I think you're right. He was trying to send a message there. That was that weak side pick and roll again. Delaware's got to have an extra defender over there to facilitate at least some activity to get in the roller's way.
Delaware leads 31-29 after the dunk by Green. Green having a good night, 6 points. Inside Carter, hanging, missing, following his shot, missing again, and a whistle on the rebound. I believe, unless it was a late whistle on the shot, as Carter holding, looks like his left hand. And it looks like Carter will go to the free throw line. So it was on the second attempt by Carter, a late whistle.
Scott, that was a really clever pass by Darian Bryant, almost through the legs of the defender to drop it off. He used the right pass, which was a bounce pass, but throwing it at exactly the right place, almost like a quarterback throws a receiver open, led Eric Carter into that, which eventually led to the fouls.
Carter's now made 17 of his last 20 free throws, and prior to that span was shooting 59% from the free throw line. Really good concentration from the stripe.
Absolutely. The more you get there, especially in a game as it goes on, if you're shooting 4 or 5 every half, you're going to be in more rhythm. I've always liked Eric Carter's release on his foul shots.
He's got 8 points now, leading Delaware. Balanced scoring attack. Everyone that has entered the game has scored for the Hens at a 4-point lead for Delaware, 33-29. Murphy. Highly acclaimed freshman on the post, kicks it out to Gresham. Gresham on the drive, stops. Walker comes over to help. Didn't want to pick up that third foul, and Gresham able to score creatively with his right hand.
Gresham is really strong. He's got a wonderful first step. He's very good at attacking the basket and one of their best on-the-ball defenders.
Both teams, again, shooting 50% still in this basketball game, a 33-31 lead. For Delaware, as he gets in their offense straight away, it's Bryant. Bryant taking Pusheets off the dribble. Corner three, Walker off the rim and out. Not a high percentage three-point shooter. Kyrie Walker just 5 of 21 on this season.
I think sometimes Walker and Jacob Cushing, if they look to make the extra pass, we might be getting even a better look. It's not a terrible shot, just one of those where it's a little early. It was a nice split by Darian Bryant to draw the help.
Timeout on the floor with 3:23. It's our last timeout of the first half. Delaware holding on to a 2-point advantage, 33-31.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Current lessees switch to GMC and get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Terrain SLE for around $249 per month with $999 due at signing.
We're home.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that?
It's a brand new Buick Enclave.
That really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does.
Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave, tomorrow's SUV. For today's family, current Buick lessees, get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Buick Enclave for around $399 per month.
Powertrain warranty on any vehicle purchase. 6 years or newer with up to 84,000 miles. Find new roads with it. ChevroletOfDover.com. 3:23 to go. 33-31. The Delaware lead. They've trailed by as many as six. It was 6-0 early. Delaware answered with an 8-0 run at that time. And it's gone back and forth, or has been close at least, since that point in the basketball game. Delaware taking care of the basketball, as they always seem to do.
They certainly do. And I love the fact we're playing at a good speed. We're working the shot clock down, which minimizes possessions, obviously, for us, but minimizes those for Northeastern as well. A little bit easier to run your offense than to play tough defense, especially with a short bench.
How about Delaware? They've not missed a free throw yet. We've talked about the woes of Delaware shooting free throws this season. They are 6 of 6. 4 of those coming from the hand of Eric Carter. Northeastern with the basketball after the timeout. 10 to shoot. Pusheets near half court sees it. Will operate with his left hand. Out of the right, centers it. Wants a three-point shot, pulls up after a head fake and rattles one through. 17 already for Vasa Pushita. He is over his season average per game.
And he's had some other very good looks as well. I just like this pace that he plays at. He's a very smart player who also is engaged defensively for Northeastern.
Delaware's had seven guys score 30 points against them this season. Pushita pacing towards that, and none do it a season ago. 13 to shoot for Carter. Banging with Murphy, spinning, baseline. Murphy, the rookie, get big.
Fantastic move by Eric Carter as he works into his left shoulder. He then drop steps in what we call a seal move, where he seals off the defender on the high side and works his left hand on the left side of the court. What a terrific individual post move. Credit Billy Phillips.
Let me show you something, young man. That's what Eric Carter said to him. Double figures now for Eric. He's got 10. Brace the corner three. Allen trying to tip it to a teammate. Does so. Bryant control.
Good job there by Delaware, scrambling around and continuing to do a good job on their defensive glass.
A 35-34 lead for Delaware. Already seven lead changes in this first half. Allen on the wing. He's got 6 points. A three-pointer is up off the mark, and he'll start 0 of 3 from distance. Brace on the run after the rebound. Leaves his feet to pass to Gresham on his way down. Corner to Begley. Pushita has 17. Kick out Gresham. Didn't catch the ball cleanly, so he'll drive to the rim and score. He thought about shooting that three, but because of the catch, decided to put it on the court and does so successfully up and through. Chance for a three-point play.
That's very good offensive basketball by Northeastern. The ball reversed court twice. It went into the middle of the lane. They got Delaware kind of stranded in between help and recovering. And that's just a tough play. And then Gresham taking advantage of driving the ball in on the defense as it had re-expanded to accommodate the three-point line.
Gresham with 6 points after the free throw is good. 1:44 to play in this first half. Second foul on Allen, calling a moment ago. It's a seventh on Delaware. Free throws for both teams at the next whistle as both teams in the bonus. Bryant stands center circle. Now to Allen, guarded closely by Begley, an All-CAA defensive team selection a year ago, but not showing signs there as Allen takes him to the cup.
Allen did a great job there of using his footwork, faced up and then re-faced up, drove down the right side and finished with his right hand. Excellent individual offense.
8 points for Allen. Miller turns to the foul line, finds Begley. Begley's three airs over the rim into the hands of Darian Bryant. A timeout taken by Martin Inglesby. He'll get two more offensive possessions. Wants to talk about it. Can't take that timeout in the locker room, so we will stay right here. Bill, Delaware coming out against a second-place Northeastern team and showing the offensive ability that Coach Inglesby wanted them to come out with. And then defensively, they've lost Pushita a couple times, but other than him, no one else hurting the Hens right
now. Well, we've been scrambling. We've done a much better job of blocking out and getting those loose balls in the 50-50 area. You've got to extend and do a little bit better job on the three, as you already mentioned. And then offensively, keep doing what we've been doing. I think we have good balance. We've driven the ball when appropriate. Ryan Allen's done a nice job that way because he will get defenders up on him on the outside because they want to deny the three-point shot. And then he's got terrific footwork and a wonderful first step to blow by people. And what I like about him, once he goes, he can also find Eric Carter, one of the bigs on the weak side. He's a willing passer when he goes to the basket, not just a scorer.
We're courtside from the ValueDaysFuel.com broadcast table. Value Days at participating Shell and Dash-In stations throughout Delaware. 10 cents off on diesel every Monday, 20 cents off premium on Tuesday, and today 5 cents off per gallon on all grades of gasoline each Thursday. Delaware out of the timeout as Carter on the elbow left. Now right wing, it's Allen. 14 to shoot for him. Above the arc is Ryan Allen. Picks up his dribble, passes to Mosley. Mosley left side, left wing. It's Walker. He'll drive baseline, cut off. 6 to shoot as Mosley has a deep left side. Operates, kicks out. Bryant, an open look at a three. He's made one, won't make another. And now a 6-second differential for Northeastern on the game clock and the shot clock.
Good split and kick there by Mosley. Darian Bryant had his feet set, but just finished off a little short. Again, I think if we're going to attack late, it needs to start a little bit earlier. Give us another 4 seconds.
Pushita stands center circle. 13 to shoot, 17 to play. Begley with it now. Back to Pushita. A couple steps beyond the arc, between the legs dribble. He'll pull up NBA range straight away. It's strong. Offensive rebound. Begley puts it up with 6 seconds left. He thought the shot clock was expiring, and Carter will grab the rebound and just settle on a tie score before we head into the locker room. 37 all at the break. Hens get the stop at the end.
A nice twist there, playing a little 2-3 zone. A good job at the top to challenge that shot by Vasa Bushitska. And I like the fact that Delaware ends up on a very positive note. Even though we didn't get a great shot at the other end, we used the clock to our advantage again, minimizing possessions for Northeastern.
Delaware shooting 15 of 30, Northeastern 14 for 30, but the Huskies have made 6 3-pointers, and we are tied at the half, 37 all. We'll take a timeout when we come back. Benny Pinella back in the studio. It's your IBEW Local 313 halftime report.
Into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score. Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition, you can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking the example of it. But now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders.
Gender.
Or race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listening to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport.
Let's change lives.
Let's create.
Let's create.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Six spin move on the left side. I just like the fact we look like we're connected. We look like we're enjoying playing with one another tonight, and our defense has been really engaged. We've been hustling around, trying to run shooters off. A couple of those offensive possessions by Northeastern were as solid an offense as I've seen in a long time by a CAA team, and Delaware's right there, a couple threes right literally on the last tick of the shot clock. Yeah. But that's got to be very encouraging to Martin Inglesby, especially with the short bench. I thought he did a really good job of resting Ryan Allen, getting him in a couple minutes there. At around the 7 minute mark, and Ryan Allen has two fouls. He's got to be very careful here for about the first 8 minutes of this half, not to get any what I would call those indiscreet fouls or those silly fouls where he's just kind of reaching in. Let a guy score once in a while. Don't foul him around the basket unless it's the end game where you have to.
Ryan has fouled out in two of the last three contests. Let's get you all the first half stats presented by Rufo Associates. Visit RufoLaw.com. For Northeastern, led by Vasa Pushica, 17 points for the Serbian transfer from San Diego. No one else in double figures, but six for Anthony Green. He was 3 of 3 against Delaware up in Boston, 3 of 3 in the first half tonight. 6 points for Donnell Gresham, two of those coming from the free throw line. 5 points for Bolden Brace, made a wide open three-point look. 3 points for Devon Begley. And then you look at the starters, and Max Borsico, who averages over 5 points per game, but Sean Osius, both of these players, no points in a combined 16 minutes of action. Sean Osius, second leading scorer on the team, 11 points per game, and he's been struggling as of late. Hasn't reached double figures in four of his last five games, 3 games in a row, and unless he does something special in the second half of this one, might be looking at 4 games in a row under 10 points. Hens have done a nice job on him. Northeastern shooting 47% from the field, 38% from three. They made 6 of 16 and 3 of 4 from the free throw line. For Delaware, 10 points for Eric Carter, double figures once again, and 6 rebounds leading the team in both of those categories. 8 points for Ryan Allen, not far behind in 18 minutes of work. 6 points for Anthony Mosley, 2 of 5 from the field for him. 2 assists and a steal in 19 minutes of action for Anthony Mosley. Thought he got up to a really good start for the Hens. 4 rebounds as well for the point guard from Samford School. 5 points for Darian Bryant, good to see him. Hit a couple shots, one close one from long range, and he had 5 points total in the last 2 games, so really good to see him contributing on the offensive end in the first half. 4 points for Kyrie Walker, 2 points for Sky Johnson, 2 for Jacob Cushing. Delaware shooting 50% from the field, 15 of 30, just 1 of 8 from 3-point range, though. Nothing from Ryan Allen, who's made a 3-pointer in all 22 of his games thus far, so looking for a triple to make it 23. 6 of 6 from the free throw line. Delaware 18 points in the paint, Northeastern with 14. Delaware, though, 10 points off of Northeastern's 5 turnovers, only 2 points off of turnovers for Northeastern, because Delaware only 2 turnovers in the game. Delaware will come out with their starters: Carter, Cushing, Bryant, Mosley, and Allen. They'll defend first as Northeastern comes out with their starters: Gresham, Borsico, Green, Pushitsa, and Osius. Northeastern will go left to right as we see it across from the Delaware bench. Hens in the home white, Northeastern in the road blacks. Bill Cohen, head coach of Northeastern, Delaware coach by Martin Inglesby, and we are underway for second half basketball. Anthony Green with a handoff to Osius. Osius attacking, but he picked up the basketball, dropped it, couldn't grab it again, and out of bounds it went. A little indecisiveness from Osius.
The lefty was trying to drive down the lane and I think affect Darian Bryant into a foul. Bryant did a nice job of leveling him off, not allowing him a straight line drive, creating the turnover.
Some really solid defenders on this team. You look at Mosley and Bryant in that starting lineup. Here's Carter, left block on Green. 18 to shoot. Carter double team, triple team, Cushing, baseline drive, bounce pass, corner, Bryant, kick out, Allen open for a 3-point look, 23 games in a row.
A great job going into Eric Carter on the left side, then a pass through by Cushing, and another extra pass to Ryan Allen open on the left side. Really nice offense by Delaware, switching the sides of the court.
And Delaware starts with a 3-point advantage, 40-37. That whistle you heard was that third on Ryan Allen, and that's one of those cheapies that you kind of described.
And you could see that we're good coaching. Bill Cohen over there really applauding Gresham for attacking immediately on the reversal of Ryan Allen to get him that third foul. So Ryan Allen's got to be very careful here. I think coach has got to play him for a while and see if he can play through the foul trouble.
Pushitsa's pass deflected into the hands of Borsico. Johnny on the spot gets a layup along the right side. Got to trust Allen, but Allen's got to be able to prove he can play with those three fouls. He picked up a technical foul in the Elon game, which gave an extra personal. Now a steal. Borsico streaking down the floor. Cushing tries to time his jump, but he fouls Borsico in transition. So after the three-pointer by Allen, a turnover, a bucket, and now a chance for two at the line.
After taking such great care of the ball in the first half, Delaware just a little careless there, not communicating well with their body positioning. I like the play, though, by Jacob Cushing. Instead of fouling late on the floor, Jacob tried to time his jump and block the shot, but that meant the shot had no chance of going in, so there was no possibility of a three-point play. So smart defense there in retreat after the turnover.
Just the third turnover, as you mentioned. Delaware's first of this half. Borsico makes the free throw, knots the game at 40, can give Northeastern their first second half lead, and does so with the free throw. Borsico, the sophomore from Ottawa, Ontario. And Bill, you were noting, this is a pretty young Northeastern team. Mentioned a sophomore at the line.
Yes, it is. Sophomores, and they come off with Murphy, the freshman, and only 2 juniors, so no seniors starting or playing much minutes for them.
Bryant, corner to Mosley. Mosley a jab step, 12 to shoot. He brings it back out. Good man-to-man defense by Donnell Gresham. Cushing with 7 to shoot, wing left. Driving, baseline, behind the back dribble. Borsico takes it away. Too much dribbling by the Hens. But a possible turnover as Northeastern saves it to a teammate. Pushitsa had to track it down along the sideline. Tapped it to Osius, and now he drives on the right side. Pushitsa to Gresham. Swing over to Osius. Osius with 15 to shoot, 2 minutes in. A 41-40 lead for Northeastern. Couple turnovers forced to start this second half. 7 to shoot for Sean Osius. Pass the foul line. Green, too strong for Boris to go to handle underneath and a turnover right back. That was a strong pass, to say the least.
Poor Billy Cohen just didn't know even what to do there emotionally after that pass by Green. Just, he's such a powerful man, but he almost was going to take off the feet of his teammate down in the post-up position. But Delaware kind of handling again a nice possession until the turnover by Northeastern with good engagement defensively.
Hens on offense. Couple of turnovers and an Allen three-point make on the first three trips. They'll reverse the ball around the perimeter, trying to get it into Carter eventually, but an illegal screen, and there it is. It's one per game, Bill, on Eric Carter. It's unfortunate, but he has turned the ball over and picked up a foul in almost every game this year with the illegal screen.
And in fairness to Eric, he screens a lot, so there's an opportunity for that, but as a screener, you've got to be totally set. Do not move your hips, your shoulders, or your arms.
Delaware three turnovers on four possessions in the second half after only two turnovers in 20 minutes in the first. Green kicks out Gresham. Gresham attacking, gets Carter in the air. One official saw it as a clean block. The other whistles Carter for the foul.
Well, I think they were both right, unfortunately, in the sense of Eric drawing the foul. He blocked the ball cleanly up top but got him with his lower body, so a good job there officiating from Northeastern's perspective. Eric's got to just stay grounded there. Don't worry about trying to block that shot so quickly. Gresham is going to have to show a shot fake anyway on you in there. You don't want to rise up right away. Gresham's scouting report is when he goes inside, he will use some fakes. Eric's just got to be a little bit more careful.
Second foul on Carter. Four fouls now for Delaware as the second free throw no good after the first was made. A 42-40 lead for Northeastern. Four fouls for Delaware. None for Northeastern, three turnovers for Delaware, and the Hens, after Allen made a quick three to start the second half, have gone scoreless for the last 2 minutes of basketball.
But Delaware only down 2 points through that miserable couple minutes here offensively and at the other end in terms of our fouls. So a good job by Delaware continuing to defend and play through these mistakes.
It's hard not to like Eric Carter. I love this guy, one of my favorite players. Anthony Green called for the foul on the inside. Carter then taps Tim Comer on the butt and says, good call.
Eric's so really smart that way. He works the officials in an intelligent player manner. And we've always remarked about how smart we think Eric Carter is.
Love Carter. He's got 10 points. Second leading scorer is Allen's up to 11. And Kyrie Walker. It was Mosley who found it.
What a terrific back door from the weak side is the expansion of Northeastern's man-to-man extended out to the three, allowed Walker to get down the backside.
Now Borsico loses it, gets it back. Layup underneath, no one was there to prevent the layup.
Borsico off to a really good start, just getting inside and also getting to the foul line here. Delaware's got to shore up their lane defense. We've got to have an extra defender in the lane to possibly intercept or at least affect that type of pass.
Like we talk about, you know, liking Eric Carter. These fans, and there's an offensive foul against Carter as he got an elbow up to Thomas Murphy, but just to finish my thought before you go ahead, Bill, these fans are going to love Kyrie Walker. He's got a couple of dunks tonight, and if you like exciting above the rim basketball, Kyrie Walker the next couple of years is going to provide it for you. What'd you see there from Carter?
He's a dynamic player as Walker, but what I saw down at the other end is they missed the initial contact by Murphy from behind, and then Eric Carter had to respond with that movement of his arm. So really, that was not a good job of officiating there. They missed the initial foul, which created the second one. And unfortunately, from Delaware's perspective, they always see the second one.
Here's Pushitsa, 17 points in the first half, yet to score in the second frame. His team up 44-42, 4 minutes in. Next whistle will bring us to a break. Pushitsa lob to Murphy. Murphy mistimed his jump and will take that timeout. 15:54 remaining, and Delaware down 44-42.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Current lessees switch to GMC and get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Terrain SLE for around $249 per month with $999 due at signing.
We're home.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that?
It's a brand new Buick Enclave that really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does. Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave, tomorrow's SUV for today's family. Current Buick lessees, get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Buick Enclave for around $399 per month.
Delaware down 44-42 with 15:54 remaining. I'm Zach Batson alongside Bill Harmon. Delaware warmed up in shirts that said no more. K and the W in yellow, no more in white. And it is a campaign about understanding, discussing, and preventing sexual harassment, assault, and other gender-based violence. And Delaware fans and students, you can help. Be informed and use your power. Attend no more events on campus. Speak out. Tell your friends if they're being inappropriate, and always get your partner's consent for sexual activity. Report incidents, and caring experts can help. Take the pledge. Show your commitment to raising awareness and help prevent sexual misconduct on campus. For more information, go to udel.edu/no more. KNOWMORE. Great campaign by the University of Delaware. As we get back in action, Sky Johnson underneath. He's fouled by Thomas Murphy, and he'll go to the free throw line. That's just a second foul on the Huskies. Five already for Delaware.
Delaware, unfortunately, a little too aggressive. One of them was the offensive foul by Eric Carter, and then misjudging his timing on the jump down there to defend Gresham. That was really nice interior screening there. Sky Johnson screened for Walker, but that was an illusion because he was coming across to the other side, and a terrific pass by Darian Bryant from the top of the key to get Sky in excellent position, really taking advantage of the freshman Murphy's interior defensive liability.
Delaware last in the conference in free throw percenting at 67%, but I bet if you looked at their free throw percent over the last couple of games, they would not be in that position. They are 8 of 8 tonight after Johnson makes two. We're tied at 44. Pushitsa on the wing right to Murphy as they work the ball around the arc. Pushitsa gets it back with 18 to shoot. Gresham in the corner. Allen defends. Couple of dribbles from it's Begley, who gets it to Pushitsa behind the back dribble. Walker defending. Pushitsa loses it. Taps it to a teammate. Begley with five. Kick out Pushitsa. Squares. Fires with two on the shot clock. Back rim, no. Mosley, long rebound. He's on the run. Across half court to Bryant. Bryant with the score tied. Allen cannot untie that score, but an offensive board by Sky Johnson. The cutter is Mosley, double clutching, and Delaware takes the lead.
Great effort on the offensive glass by Sky Johnson. He couldn't step in to lay it in because Murphy was on the floor at his feet. He waited for Mosley cutting down from the weak side, and a beautiful pass.
Mosley's got eight, and Delaware has the lead back. Gresham, wing right, into the corner, picks up his dribble, bounce pass to Bolden Brace, corner. It's Begley with nine to shoot. Delaware again, solid defense, spinning, Begley, wild shot, off the mark, Murphy taps it, no one's there, out of bounds it goes.
Murphy works extremely hard inside, a little ungangly at times, almost could have had a foul there on Walker. That was great defense. What Delaware's done by getting out and defending the three, they forced Northeastern to kind of stand around offensively, so Delaware doing a nice job of forcing Northeastern out of their rhythm.
Jeremy Miller comes in for Thomas Murphy. Miller did not play the last two games. Coach's decision. He's a former preseason All-CAA selection. Entry passer Mosley to Sky Johnson is too wide for Sky, and a turnover as he tried to save it out of bounds was late in doing so.
Well, Miller is very long-armed. He was playing Sky Johnson from the inside with a high arm, and Anthony Mosley was trying to throw it down to the baseline. Just misjudged it and threw it a little too far. I think sometimes there, the extra dribble down and a direct pass instead of the lob might be more effective.
Delaware, five turnovers in this half after two in half number one. We've only played 6 minutes of basketball. Pushitsa inside, drawing contact on Sky Johnson. That's a sixth foul on Delaware, so Northeastern will be shooting free throws the rest of the game, and there's 14 minutes left.
Yes, Northeastern's come out with a strategy. They wanted to get Ryan Allen in early foul trouble, get that third one right away. He's done a nice job of maintaining his composure defensively. They've been trying to bump him defensively every time they cut through, trying to create one of those cheap fouls that we talked about. But they're going to drive the ball at every opportunity here, especially when Eric Carter is in the game. They feel that we don't have enough rim protection, so they're going to attack and try to either draw fouls or get into the lane and make those in-close shots.
And they're doing a good job. Allen has three. Carter has three. A missed free throw after making the first by Pushitsa. Northeastern 7 of 10 today from the line. And Allen playing with the three. On the bench with the three fouls is Eric Carter. Allen driving to Mosley. Corner left. Brings it back out with 16 to shoot. Walker. One dribble and a pass to Bryant on the wing in front of Delaware's bench right side. Screen comes Johnson. Dribbles inside the arc. Attacking the rim. Bryant finds the angle.
Bryant rejected the Sky Johnson screen on the top side on the right part of the court. Then drives along the baseline. Finishes through contact. He's been very aggressive finding those driving lanes.
Northeastern has not scored a field goal in 3 minutes as Pushitsa leaves it in for Miller. He dropped it. Ball batted away. There was a reset on the shot clock, and there should not have been. So that's a stoppage on the floor with 13-18.
We talked to the Northeastern staff about Jeremy Miller. They really like him, and they think he has tremendous upside, but at times he doesn't get himself quite involved in the game. And that time he just wasn't alert enough on the backside to garner that pass, and he should have had that in for a dunk.
And Miller, if you remember back a couple years ago, he was kind of the prize for Northeastern for winning that CAA tournament. He was recruited by Boston College, by Maryland out of the Big Ten, Providence out of the Big East, came to Northeastern and shows potential but hasn't found it this year. Gresham with one on the shot clock, a miss, a tap by Allen to Mosley, who grabs the rebound on the corner left side, eyes up the floor. Walker driving baseline, Brace, nice job cutting him off, and he cut him off so far along the baseline that Walker stepped out of bounds.
Brace did a terrific job there as an on-the-ball defender. When the ball is driven to the baseline, you want to do two things. Move the bottom foot first and keep your baseline hand down, which allows you to even be longer that way. And that's really what forced Kyrie Walker to dribble the ball out of bounds, just stepped out. So that was good individual defense there by Bolden Brace, the sophomore from Santa Barbara, California.
Delaware, a three-point advantage. Did Northeastern not travel with a trainer? There's a stoppage on the floor because Vasa Pushitsa has a bloody knee. He ran over to the bench, grabbed the towel himself, no one helping him. And now he's going to put a wrap on his leg as there's a somewhat of a timeout. We'll stay right here for the injury to Vasa Pushitsa. It looks like Northeastern, they were going to have to get Paul Lowry, our guy, over to help out. Pushitsa putting a sleeve on his leg to cover up the blood. And now we can resume action. Either there's a slow-to-act trainer on Northeastern's side or none at all.
Well, Pushitsa did a nice job there of getting himself bandaged up. And,
he did it all himself.
Re-engaged.
I've never seen that
in
before.
The game. I agree with you. So the man from Serbia knows
how to handle
himself.
He did a little bit of everything. He's got 18 points. Right. He's got 4 rebounds, 2 assists, and an assist for himself on the medical table. We're back in action. Brace, Pushitsa, Gresham, Miller, and Begley on the floor. Only 2 starters playing right now for Northeastern. Same for Delaware. 3 starters for Delaware is Mosley, Allen, and Bryant, joined by Walker and Johnson off the bench. It's Pushitsa picking up his dribble. Begley attacking. His pass is deflected. Walker tips it to Pushitsa. Pushitsa in the paint. Kick out Gresham. Open look at a 3. Donnell Gresham hits. And Gresham's in double figures.
Gresham, we did a great job of what we call cracking back, coming at an angle behind as Pushitsa went into the lane and then did a nice job jump stopping and delivering the ball right in to his shooting pocket.
Score tied at 48. Allen with the basketball guarded by Begley. Screen comes left by Johnson. Allen does not use it. Passes to Mosley. 9 to shoot. Anthony Mosley beyond the arc. Dribbling. 6 to shoot. Foul line. Johnson attacking Miller. And a whistle as Miller on the reach-in foul before the shot attempt. So it'll be Delaware basketball and the score tied at 48 when we come back. You're listening to Blue Hen Sports Radio Network 94.7 WDSD.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking the example of it, but now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders.
Gender.
A race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listening to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport.
Let's change lives.
Let's create.
Let's create.
A good day for pizza. I'm Scott Gladstein alongside Bill Harmon. It's 48-all, 11:59 to play. We've got a good one here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Delaware, we praise them for taking care of the basketball in that first half. Only two turnovers. They've got six second-half turnovers, a total of eight.
And it's just been some unfortunate ball handling, a couple miscommunications, an offensive foul. They all add up, but that's very uncharacteristic of the way Delaware's been playing. And I think it's remarkable with so many fouls early on and those turnovers that Delaware is still knotted up here. And I think they've done a good job of just staying involved defensively and not giving in.
Delaware shooting 54% from the field in this contest. And they've got the basketball with Walker on the wing. Passing around the arc, it's Bryant. Screen comes Johnson. Bryant double team. Looking to pass out. Cross court pass to Walker in front of the Delaware bench. Posting up is Johnson. Walker attacks. Hangs, scores. What a move, a stop by Walker and an elevation.
He's so athletic. That balance that you just referred to was extraordinary, driving in hard with his left hand and then getting himself squared up and releasing.
He's got 8 points. Now Johnson a foul, wanted the jump ball, had an argument, but instead Johnson called for Delaware's seventh of the half.
Well, this officiating crew's had a little bit more difficult time here in the second half with a lot of involvement around the basket areas. I thought Sky went up and actually got enough of a piece of it to create that, but Timmy Comer and his crew decided differently.
It's a third on Johnson, so Delaware, this is where we remind our listeners that Delaware has seven scholarship players, so with players in foul trouble, that does become an issue. Martin Inglesby's bench is very short. It's a long bench. There's guys on it. Colin Goss, I love to see him, 6'11 transfer. He can't play. Ryan Daly's in a boot, and we see a larger boot. But a full leg cast, if you will, or some type of protection for Kevin Anderson. So he's got guys, but they just can't play.
I watched Kevin Anderson talk to him before the game. He's really moving along very quickly with his rehab, Scott, moving almost as well as any of us do with two legs, and he's on a leg and a half.
Gresham splits the pair. It's 50 for Delaware, 49 for Northeastern as Allen has the basketball. Johnson goes to the bench, Carter comes in, so Johnson with three fouls, substituted by Carter with three fouls. Bad pass by Bryant trying to squeeze one into Carter, and it's taken away. That's a seventh second half turnover for Delaware. They're up to nine.
Just no room there. There was too much congestion in the lane. Bryant should have just withdrawn the ball with the dribble or turned and reverse pivoted and thrown the ball out to the perimeter.
Plenty of time on the shot clock when he did it. Gresham inside to Green. Green goes up for the power slam. He's short, gets it back, and uses two hands to make sure it goes through on the second try.
That was just a big-time man play. He goes up, gets his first shot, affected a little bit off balance, missed the dunk, and then stays with it. Eric Carter really didn't have much opportunity there and couldn't foul.
Green had eight against Delaware earlier in the season, eight tonight. And a lead back for Northeastern, 51-50. Carter, as the double team comes, picks up his dribble, whips a pass top of the key to Bryant. He spins off a defender. Another pass deflection. This time Walker's there to pick it up. Can't score, but he is fouled. He'll go to the free throw line, where he shoots just 37%.
Kyrie Walker had terrific patience in the lane. He waited before he stepped underneath to create the foul. A lot of players would have gone up right away. I thought he was very smart there in reserving his jump until the last moment to create the foul. What one thing that Northeastern's done differently here in the second half, they've been digging down off the passer every time the ball's going into Eric Carter or Sky Johnson Lowe when they've had an opportunity.
Walker at the stripe, makes the first free throw. That's big for Kyrie Walker. Doesn't get a whole lot of trips to the free throw line. He'll get a whole lot more as his playing career goes on because of his ball game, which is high above the rim and near the rim as Cushing comes in for Darian Bryant.
Scotty, let's not forget Jacob Cushing continues to play with that mask that we've talked about since he's come back from that injury. in December, and he really plays extremely hard. It gives him a little trouble of vision around the basket, and it's a little uncomfortable, but his peripheral vision is good, and his breathing is fine.
Pushidza, his vision's just fine, but he missed the layup. He's got around the defender, and score still tied at 51 as Walker made one of two, and Delaware with the basketball. Under 10 minutes we go. Walker beyond the arc, driving foul line. Pull-up jumper, Kyrie Walker off the mark and into the hands of Anthony Green.
It was not a bad look. I like the fact that Kyrie's not settling for the three, driving in off the bounce.
Pushidza driving in as well and coming to crash as Kyrie Walker. Some confusion on the defensive matchups as soon as the foul was called, Cushing kind of raced over to Anthony Mosley to ask for an assignment of sorts.
I think they were looking to switch that exchange and did not do it, and that allowed Pushidza to get down the lane. He's been attacking with his right hand throughout this second half. He missed a layup but got in earlier a couple of times. Delaware's got to make sure that they level him off early on because he's very clever around the basket.
Pushidza had 17 first half points. He only has two here in the second half, both coming from the free throw line, so they've done a better job with him. And he makes them both. Lead is two for Northeastern. 9 ties, 12 lead changes in this basketball game. Delaware's led for 12 minutes. Northeastern's led for 11 minutes. And Cushing's pass too strong for Mosley to handle, and another turnover. That's 8 second-half turnovers in only 10 and a half minutes.
I love the fact that Martin is doing a good job of reserving his timeouts, but maybe at some point here, maybe one just to settle us down and get us into a little better flow. This is not the result of great defense. Actually, Northeastern's kind of being passive. It's more just our non-communications and some errant passes.
Some unforced errors by Delaware. That's a good point, Bill. 53-51 as Pushidza gets Carter in the air and scores after the pump fake.
We talked about what a crafty player he is. He uses fakes. He plays at a good speed. He doesn't blow by you with athleticism. He does it with skill and vision.
And there's that timeout you suggested, Bill. Martin Inglesby calls a timeout. We'll take a break with him. 9:02 remaining, and Delaware trails by 4. Their biggest second-half deficit is 55-51.
Puts it into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
I can't even see the score. Oh, my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen? It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition, you can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
By Martin Inglesby settling his team as they trail 55-51 on 94.7 WDSD-FM. And I feel like we've seen this story unfold before. Delaware playing and hanging with a higher-rated opponent in the standings, and then at the end of the ball game, kind of losing control. And because of that reason, a good timeout taken by Martin Inglesby.
Oh, I really like that timeout. It settles the team down, tries to break the momentum of Northeastern. I thought Billy Cohen did a nice job, the Northeastern coach, of playing Devin Bagley more, using the 6'4" height and experience of the senior to play Ryan Allen a little bit more in this second half that maybe has kind of distracted Ryan Allen due to that height.
He's limited him. Only one field goal attempt after that initial three-point make to start the second half. He had 8 shot attempts in the first half, trying to create for himself, gets himself to the foul line, around and out on the jump shot, and a whistle against Northeastern on the rebound by Donnell Gresham.
Well, sometimes as a defensive rebounder, you push yourself. Many times that's more the result of an offensive rebounder trying to get additional protection and position. At that time, the foul was just unruly hand check inside.
Five fouls on Northeastern. Allen drops it for Mosley, another turnover. Not a good pass by Ryan Allen in traffic. Several turnovers inside the paint for Delaware. Brace, kick out, Gresham, open three on the other end, and a turnover leading to points for Northeastern.
And that's where we've got to be tougher with the ball. We've got to make a bounce pass, not an air pass. Good offense there by Northeastern. This is the state of today's game where you pass up a layup for a three-point shot.
Largest lead of the night for Northeastern. It's 7, 58-51. A lot of basketball left. Mosley to Walker. Beyond the arc, Carter calling for it. He wants it. Banging with Anthony Green. Allen doesn't go to him, but he does attack the rim. Use the left hand. An errant layup is a miss. And some frustration on the face of Ryan Allen. A whistle as the shot clock did not start. That's a break for Delaware as Northeastern was in transition. And they were looking to attack as the clock was stopped.
Well, you're right, and that was a lucky break because they had numbers at the end. At the other end offensively, Ryan Allen trying to create some activity, but he had Eric Carter down on the left block wide open. Dump the ball into him, relocate, see if your man digs on Eric Carter. We need to go back in through Eric Carter, get ourselves stabilized, slow the play down, and then Ryan Allen can attack once he's relocated and Eric Carter throws the ball back out of the post.
They're working on the shot clock. It's set to 28, so we should be good to go, but both teams have gone to their benches. It was 51-all, a 7-0 run by Northeastern, making it 58-57. 8:23 to play, and the officiating crew at the table. I understand in these situations you want to get it exactly right, but I feel like right now the conversation that has taken now probably over 2 minutes is to find out whether the clock should be at 8:22 or 8:24, and I understand that you want to get it correct, but there is no way that either team or either coaching staff would care if it's at 8:25, 8:21, or 8:23. So I just think that needs to be fixed in college basketball. It's good enough at this point in the game. Under 2 minutes, I understand it. 8 minutes left, one or two ticks.
I agree with you. It throws the game's rhythm off, and players need to play, and coaches need to coach, officials need to officiate. This is not the first time we've had some problems with the shot clock here and the possession clock. So Delaware's just going to have to figure out this mechanically. And we've got a great staff here. It's not their fault. This is more of a technical error that the officials have to deal with.
Unless, Bill, they're looking at something extracurricular and they're looking at a flagrant or a technical. That's my only other guess is that
I didn't see anything going on the court at the time, and there was no movement by the officials to suggest that was the case.
Tim Comer over the table with Jeremy Mosier. Now having a conversation with the operators at the table.
The only good thing here is, Scott, this kind of acts as another slowdown to Northeastern's onslaught here in these last few minutes. Settles Delaware down, slow down. Let's get a great defensive possession and get a really good look at the offensive end.
And they took an extra second off the clock on the shot clock, and they took actually 20 more seconds off the clock. So there was a very large difference. So I understand a little bit more now, as it was at 8:23, as it was inbounded at 8:02, and now it stands at 7:51. So I understand that more of a difference, 20 seconds, a bigger difference in this basketball game than the one or two that I assumed it was for. Pushitsa a three, and he needs about a half a second to release that one. Knocks it through, and 25 points for the Serbian.
Delaware has went to a 2-3 zone and unfortunately didn't have a man close enough to the Serbian shooter on the right-hand side.
61-51, a first 10-point lead in this basketball game as Johnson drives, leaves it for Bryant, back on top to Mosley. Allen's got to go to work on Osius, a heck of a defender. Nothing there. Osius stops him. Six to shoot for Mosley. Mosley with five. Top of the key with three. Inside with two. Floats it rim. No rebound. Mosley misses again. Johnson is there to put it up and through.
It starts with Mosley getting in deep enough to get a good look at the basket. Stays with his miss, and then Sky Johnson cleans it up. That was really good activity. Delaware staying in this 2-3 zone. We've got to make sure we know where the Serbian is located and having a man, half a man towards him.
And that's Vasa Pushica, who's up to 25 points. Northeastern has made 9 3-pointers on the night. Gresham, corner to Osius. Can they get double-digit threes? A miss from Osius, and he's got nothing on the board. with 6:32 remaining. Allen all the way to the cup. Ryan Allen, the rookie of the week.
Well, Osius took that three-point shot, sprints across the court. He should have just connected with Brace, who should have defended Ryan Allen, who recognized neither man was playing him in front of the Delaware bench, and then attacks the basket. A good way to get yourself going here.
Four quick ones for Delaware, and now a steal. A pass into the hands of Darian Bryant. Carter comes away with it, and back to Darren it goes. Hands down 61-55 as Mosley drives. Corner to Allen. Allen squares, fires, gets good rotation, but it's short, and Green with the rebound.
Donnell Gresham did a nice job there closing out Ryan Allen, who did have a look, and he's got a very quick release. But Gresham's high hand contest was just enough to bother Ryan Allen at the top of his jump.
Allen thought he was fouled, a conversation, a polite one, with the official on his way back playing defense. Now a steal, ball too high for Green to handle. On the run is Allen. Allen to Bryant on the wing, fouled on his way up, but no whistle. Sky Johnson collects the miss and puts it back up and through. A 6-0 run for Delaware, a timeout by Bill Cohen and Northeastern, and we'll take a break with 5:33 remaining. Delaware marching back down 61-57.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing. It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
The count. Delaware on a 6-0 run after going down by 10. And join us for the next Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show, presented by First Air Orthopedics, live from Klondike Cates on Main Street. The next show will be on Monday. Join us February 12th. Mark your calendars, 7 to 8 o'clock. And remember, every time the Blue Hens basketball team wins, bring in your ticket stub or share the final score graphic on social media, and you'll receive 20% off of dinner the next day at Klondike Cates. Proud supporter of Delaware basketball and the Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show. 61-57, Delaware able to battle back over the last 88 seconds because of some turnovers, some sloppy play by Northeastern.
Northeastern kind of playing very inconsistently, as we talked about, but Sky Johnson twice working the offensive glass. That last one, he ran rim to rim to finish up on the miss there by Darren Bryant, who we both thought got fouled. Delaware continues to play this 2-3 zone that I think has been a good factor here in the second half to confuse Northeastern's attack.
Brace to Gresham on the wing. Mosley and Allen on top of that zone. They go back and forth. To Miller, elbow right. Sky Johnson defends. Gresham working it over to Begley. Back to Gresham. Long range three, and Donnell Gresham makes the 10th triple of the night for Northeastern.
That's just a tough shot. Wow. He was pretty well defended there. Sometimes the offense a little better than the defense.
Allen driving, attacking. Underneath two defenders, he scores. Will they count it on the continuation? I don't believe so on the floor, but that's the sixth foul on Northeastern. Wow, Delaware has picked up, was in the bonus earlier. Northeastern was in the bonus early, and still Delaware, no free throws on that attack from Allen. Allen gets it back, though, off the inbound. Spins to the rim, challenging Jeremy Miller, pounding his chest after the layup through.
What a terrific job by Ryan Allen attacking the midsection of Jeremy Miller as he came across. Not a great rim protector, but great offense at the rim by Ryan Allen.
And Pushitsa travels on the other end. Delaware on a run here. 64-59. It's an 8-3 run. And another turnover by Northeastern. They're up to 11.
And a quick substitution by Billy Cohen, getting Miller out of the game and getting Green back in, who's a much better rim defender.
4:37 to play. Delaware trails by five. It's 64-59. as Mosley walks it up. Allen's got 15 points. Carter flashing at the foul line, gets it above the foul line, inside to Johnson. Two bigs playing at the same time. Johnson loses it, gets it back. 4:21 to play, 12 to shoot. Johnson slips, picks up his dribble, back out to Bryant. Deep left side, 7 to shoot. Bryant with 5 to shoot. 4 to shoot for Bryant, a pass to Carter. 2 to shoot. Carter has to force one up, and he's bailed out by a foul called against Northeastern's Vasa Pushica.
Well, that was very fortunate for Delaware. I don't know why Pushica fouled Eric Carter there in the act. He had no business to even be that close to him. Eric Carter was in that, not panic stage by him, but with the shot clock expiring. Sky Johnson had a little trouble staying vertical there a couple times.
Did.
But I love the fact he had the presence of mind to keep his dribble, and then he could stand back up, really battling hard. I like a little change up here, bringing the two bigs in at the same time.
It's a starting lineup that Delaware went with the past couple of nights. And Carter continues to look good from the free throw line. 6 of 6 after that make. Delaware makes it a one possession game, 64-61. Carter, his 8th double-double of the season. He has 12 points and 10 rebounds. Double figure rebounding for the 11th game this season. Hens looking for a stop as we go under 4 minutes. Last media timeout coming up. Pushica, top of the key, 7 to shoot for Gresham. Another NBA range three, grazes the side of the rim, and Delaware can tie with a 3 of their own on this possession. It's 64-61 Northeastern. Attacking, Carter to the rim, and Delaware trails by only one.
Boy, that's great when you can have your big man attack from the foul line. Sky Johnson did it earlier. Eric Carter, they're going down the lane with his left hand. That's how you want to move a big man like Green. Take him off the dribble.
4 in a row for Carter, 6 in a row for Delaware. And it's 64-63. Northeastern on top. Corner, Brace, a 3-point look. It's off the mark. Offensive rebound, Begley. He'll bring it back out. Pushica and Begley have a catch. Gresham will operate as the Hens could not get their hands on that miss by Bolden Brace. Pushica, foul line, Green, elbow right side. Brace, another try, another open look, and the second time around, he makes Delaware pay.
Well, the 2-3 zone should be able to accommodate the baseline shooting. Northeastern goes inside to Green, who then kicks it out to the near corner to Brace, who was wide open.
Allen trying to get two back. Fading away, baseline left, he hits. And a timeout taken by Martin Inglesby. We'll take a break with him. Delaware trails by 2, 67-65. Don't go anywhere. You're not going to miss the final 2:35 from the Bob.
Anchor Buick GMC in Elkton, Maryland.
Get Easy Pass. Easy Pass is accepted in 16 states, helping to take more people, more places fast. Get your Easy Pass online at easypassde.com. 67-65 Northeastern on top of a game that has been tied 9 times, 12 lead changes. And the Hens find themselves down by 2 with 2:35 left. We saw an open 3-point shot a moment ago by Bolden Brace against his 2-3 Delaware zone. How do you think Delaware will defend it the rest of the way?
Well, I think we may switch defenses and go back man-to-man so we can really engage and accommodate those long-range shooters. Northeastern's gotten a little bit more comfortable in their zone attack by going inside, in that case to Green, who then brought it right out. We got drawn in by a cutter from the near wing, which left Brace open on the baseline. Let's see if Delaware doesn't switch up here, but that was just better offense by Northeastern, moving the ball, going inside and then back out.
2:35 left to play. Delaware has been here before. Close games as of late. against Hofstra, against College of Charleston. These are the top teams in the conference, and it's been a star hitting a shot late that has hurt Delaware. Can they defend enough to come back and win this one after trailing by 10 in the second half? Gresham on the wing to Begley. Now Pushitsa, season opening, drives, dumps it for Green, gets Carter in the air. Carter picks up his fourth. But Green is fouled, and Green is not a good free throw shooter. He'll get two at the stripe, but just 41% on the year.
That was probably a bad decision, but a very unselfish play by Vasa Pushitsa. He gets inside low. I think he could have scored himself or gotten fouled, but he wraps so around to Green. I think that's a really, even though it's Eric Carter's fourth foul, I think that's really a good foul considering the time score.
He can play without fouling for the next 2:13, but a bucket there. You go down by two possessions. Instead, Green doesn't hit the rim. Side of the backboard on his first free throw. Adjusted, makes the second. A three-point advantage for Northeastern.
Well, that's a good trade. That's a good trade at this juncture of the game, and a smart foul by Eric Carter, not allowing Green to dunk it.
68-65. Allen, left wing. Carter wants it, gets it. Outside of the block, but on the left side. Spinning on Green. Double team comes. Gresham forcing Carter to throw it off of Green, but Carter could not get it out of the way after the ricochet. It hit Carter out of bounds and a turnover. Heady play, but he just couldn't get out of the way in time.
Anthony Green did a good job there of leveling off Eric Carter as he tried to spin to the baseline side with his right shoulder. Eric just a little unfortunate getting grazed as he tried to save it.
Delaware needs a stop. Pushitsa passing around this Delaware zone. Beyond the arc, 14 to shoot. Pushitsa wide open, and Delaware a break as he misses it. Ball goes out of bounds. Green and Bryant fought for it. It'll be Delaware basketball down by three.
One of the problems with the 2-3 zone is your block out assignments aren't very finite. Darian Bryant did a nice job of coming across, getting just enough of his body on Green as he rotated over to try to rebound the ball. So a nice play by Darian Bryant defensively on the low baseline.
The call is Delaware basketball. They are going to review it. 1:33 remaining. And as I saw it, we're on the far side of the floor from where Northeastern is shooting, and it was along that baseline. So we didn't have the best angle at it, but Green at 6'10" and Bryant at 6'4", you would think he would be on top of that basketball coming off of the rim and would have touched it last, and they would have to see something that overturns it to Delaware's possession. If it is Delaware basketball, do not need a three right now. They're down by three, but they can play this one out, and if Anthony Green's going to stay on the floor, you can try to foul him moving forward. And just get a good look, get a good bucket, like to see the ball in Allen's hands, and Carter post it up if they can.
We've done a nice job of isolating Eric Carter on the left-hand side of the block as the offense looks at him. I love it with Ryan Allen dumping the ball in, because that means if they dig off of him, he's going to be wide open for a relocate and a return pass. What they did on the last possession is bring Gresham down the lane to affect the double team. Anthony Mosley's got to communicate and get himself in a position and follow the help as they rotate down to double team. Then he can get a wide open shot in the middle of the lane himself. Delaware ball.
Delaware in close games at the Bob as of late. Lost by 4 against Towson. Lost by 5 against Hofstra. Lost by 9 against College of Charleston. That game was closer until the very end of that basketball game. So it is Delaware basketball, as you mentioned, Bill. Down by 3. Ryan Allen, the only three-point shooting threat on this Delaware team, and he has it. Left side, Begley defends. Baseline Allen, cut off, fades, high arcing. 2 is good!
What can you say? Devin Begley was all over him, read the move, and Ryan Allen's ability to elevate over top of a long arm of Begley. Terrific individual offense on the left-hand side.
That step back 2 by Allen is close to unguardable. Delaware trails by 1. 15 seconds to shoot for Northeastern as we go under a minute. Gresham to Pushitsa, wing left. Corner, it's Begley, 7 to shoot. Gresham with 5. Allen reaches in, steals it away. Mosley on the run. Gresham tries to pick his pocket, cannot. Pass to Sky Johnson, too strong. And a missed opportunity for a 3-on-1. It ends in a turnover.
Well, I think Anthony Mosley, when he looks at the tape, might be better served just trying to score there. He was passing across his body left to right as he was advancing the ball very rapidly with defenders coming back.
Now only 6 seconds differentiate the game clock and the shot clock. If Northeastern misses, Delaware has to come up with the rebound. Seven to shoot. Pushitsa to Green. Green inside, and a traveling violation will give Delaware 12 seconds to get a win.
Wow, that was good rotation by Sky Johnson to affect Green as he tried to go up there. Pushitsa got in deep and again made the mistake, I think, of dropping the ball off to Green, who could have been fouled. But even worse from Northeastern standpoint, he walks after a little bit of bump. So great job by Delaware.
11.9. Mosley lets it roll. Delaware down by one. 68-67. Allen with the ball in his hands. 7 seconds. Pulls up. Deep two. Allen around and out. Ball loose and a foul with 0.8. It was halfway down, but the spin makes it pop out, and a foul call with 0.8. I don't know if they could go to the monitor and take a look at if there could be 1 point something. But Allen forced it up. It was a good look because Allen can make those shots and has made those shots, a deep two, and it looks like Delaware might fall in another close one.
Well, I like the offense. We ran a stagger for Ryan Allen on the right side of the court, so it gets him working to his left hand where he might be able to drive it or at least get in deep enough where he could pull up off the bounces. He's done numerous times here this evening. Unfortunately, that ball had just a little bit of side spin on it, which forced it to come out. But a good look in the end game. And I like what Martin did. Instead of using a timeout and letting Northeastern's defense get set, he lets his team attack. They got a really good look. It just didn't go in.
They are going to look at the monitor. It's at 0.8 right now. And I think it might be one point something, maybe 2 seconds for Delaware. So they could get a full court, half court heave if Pushitsa, they're put 1.2. So you can't get a shot off at full court for Delaware. If I'm Pushitsa, make these two free throws, and Delaware will get a shot. Some would make the argument, miss a second, but then a miracle and you lose the game. So
Pushitsa, if you make both, you can't lose, at least in regulation.
Pushitsa, a very good free throw shooter. He'll try to do that, but this is why you practice those last second half court shots in case Delaware does get a shot at it. Delaware trailed by 10 with just under 8 minutes left in this game. Battled back, but now down by one with Pushitsa at the free throw line. Makes the first, a 2-point lead for Northeastern, 69-67. We'll talk with head coach Martin Inglesby after this basketball game.
Now Northeastern is going to get back down the floor. This, whether it's made or missed, Delaware's going to get one dribble and then a shot.
Pushitsa at the free throw line. Shot is good. So Delaware will call a timeout, and the clipboard already in hand for Martin Inglesby as Delaware goes down by three, 70-67. And somebody's going to get a look at a half-court shot if Delaware can operate it. Sometimes, though, and we've seen this before, you try to take the baseball pass, which is hard to catch, and the ball sails over. You don't get a shot off. Other times I've seen, you know, let me get the best look as I can from half-court, and you'll see an easier pass be made in kind of a hook and lateral situation that you've seen in a football game with somebody trailing. Well, it'll be interesting to see exactly what they draw up here.
Well, I think one thing from Northeastern standpoint, they will put a big man, probably Miller, on the ball to make the long pass more difficult. Now our inbounder, will step back. He can go back 3-4 feet, which allows him to potentially throw over the top, or you could actually pass across the baseline to the other side, step in, and then possibly get the ball back. But Delaware's going to – these are tough plays, but this is where coaching comes in. Martin and his staff have worked on these kinds of situations. This isn't a play he's just dialing up right now. They practice this. They probably have two or three that they use in these situations.
Referencing the Christian Laettner final shot against Kentucky
was that Duke's
had a big game tonight. LeBron James made a similar shot the other night in a long entry pass. Delaware will inbounding, though, from the baseline. And you're absolutely right, Jeremy Miller comes out on the ball. Bryant will throw it in. Mosley's at half court. Sky Johnson at the three-point arc. Cushing in one corner, Allen in the other. You'd assume Allen going to get this final shot. Delaware down by three with 1.2 remaining and a timeout taken by Bill Cohen now. He sees how Delaware lines up and how he will get his defense prepared. So both teams, a little game of chess here as Northeastern up by three. They led by 10 with 7:42 remaining. Delaware battled back, could not retake the lead, but got it within a one possession game throughout most of this, the last 6 minutes or so. Northeastern without a field goal in the final almost 3 minutes of this game.
Well, this is another one of those great efforts by Delaware, win or lose, that I've just become so impressed with. Northeastern the favorite in this game, a tough team to play, home or away. They battled them, they did everything right. They had a number of great defensive possessions. The 2-3 zone in the second half, very effective for the most part. Delaware got off to a little slow start in the second half with those turnovers and fouls, but then righted the ship. It would have been very easy to see that game when it was 7 expand out to 14, but it did not happen because of Ryan Allen and others. Sky Johnson played a huge factor in this game of battling back with some great baskets inside. And I just thought, again, Delaware continues to impress me, not worrying about their record or what, who's out on the floor, who's not out on the floor. I think we've really done another marvelous job. I'll be curious how Coach spins this one up, whether he'll change the format or not. I thought Sky Johnson was going to try to set a back pick on Anthony Mosley, throw the ball somewhere around half court. At that point, it's got to probably be Mosley the one to take the shot unless Ryan Allen can flash up to the half court line and move. For him, he should be going left to right so he could shoot it with his left hand at the basket.
And we saw a half-court make earlier in the year by Ryan Daly. Anthony Mosley made a half-court shot against Yale on the road a season ago. So Mosley has made a long-distance shot before. Carter has fouled out, so Sky Johnson will be the screen man. Cushing, Allen, and Mosley come out. Same formation here. Bryant the inbounder, Miller on the ball. Mosley at Northeastern's foul line. Sky Johnson at our three-point line and in the far baseline corners to start Cushing and Allen. Delaware down three with 1.2. Bryant runs the baseline. Baseball pass down the floor. It's touched by Allen. Out of bounds it goes. It'll be Northeastern's basketball if there's any time left, which I think there might be. And they'll want to review that because if Brace touched it last, Delaware would have a few seconds to inbound on their side of the floor. So that, interesting, as the baseball pass was deflected out of bounds, there's going to be point something on the clock, but if it's Northeastern's basketball, the game likely over. If it's Delaware's basketball, they'll get another shot.
That was really a neat play drawn up by Martin Inglesby. He had Ryan Allen in this corner, but then they crossed. He got a screen from Jacob Cushing. Then, as we thought, he works himself left to right so he could come into his own shot as he looked at it up the floor. And then Sky Johnson set another screen so Ryan Allen could work to his left hand for the shot.
And as they look at it, 0.5 remaining, but it is Northeastern's basketball. So Bolden Brace could almost just throw it off the leg of Kyrie Walker and it would be over. Brace will inbound in front of us. Near half court, back to Pushitsa in this one. Is official. 70-67. Delaware battled almost all the way back from a 10-point deficit in the second half, but Northeastern improves to 9-4 in the CAA. Delaware drops their seventh in a row.
A terrific effort at both ends by Delaware. Ryan Allen continues to impress me with his timeliness of his play. Our bigs did a great job inside. The zone was very effective. Martin really spun up a great play in the end game to give Delaware a chance. This is not one of those bad losses. This is a very fine Northeastern team who we took right to the limit here this evening, Scott.
Delaware falls 70-67, falling to 11-15 on the season, 5-8 at home, and 4-9 in conference competition. A slow walk off the court for Ryan Allen, probably thinking about that final shot that was halfway down and spun out. 19 points, though, for the young man from DeMatha, and he didn't get a chance with 1.2 as the ball was knocked out of bounds. He touched it last, and tough to swallow right now for Delaware, who's on a bit of a losing skid, but no reason to hang your head if you're Ryan Allen.